Vulfpeck's leader, Jack Stratton. Jack, it's good to have you. Thanks for joining us today.
My pleasure. Let's rock. $5 million, and it was removed under the terms violation that the artists shan't make money. That term.
So what do you want people to understand about their royalty structure? What lesson were you trying to impart on listeners?
Well, I suppose to understand their artist payout, you need a new currency. I call it the pity. There are 100 pennies in a dollar, 100 pities in a penny. And on a given play, the artist will make about 60 pities. Slight difference between the writers and the labels and whatnot, but we're fully independent.
Jack, you've got a song that was recently featured in an Apple commercial. I've been very vocally critical of Spotify. Can you see as Apple is more friendly to artists, or is this just an opportunity to make some money in a different way?
Well, everyone's litty lemonade over this IPO, but if we back up the camera and look at some business fundamentals, it's a $10 a month subscription, seven of which off the top go to rights owners. So this isn't Lipitor. I mean, come 2050, when 9.5 billion people are on this planet and the population caps, and every human, chimp, and bonobo in the Congo is listening to DJ B. Nornish, then we've got a shot. Then this is a contender. That's what you want to bet on tomorrow. That's your call. But let's focus on the fundamentals: bounce pass, jump shot, pick and roll. You know, that type of stuff.
But I don't understand. Is your problem with Spotify not paying the artists enough, or with the labels not doing a good enough deal with Spotify to get you paid more?
Well, the whole thing is jacked.